as a painter or an artist doing drawings, I've always found the blank white page or the blank brown page now for the pastels I do to be kind of terrifying. It is, doesn't really do anything for me. It doesn't have anything place to start. So I've always been able to do better with having something to react to on the page. So a while ago I learned to do blind contour drawings where you don't look at your subject, don't look at the paper, you look at your subject and you draw as if the pencil were moving around the object that you're looking at. Meanwhile, you're actually moving around the paper that you can't see. And I used to just pile up lines on top of each other and turn the piece of paper and pile up more lines. I would do that either from looking at photographs or looking at objects around me in the room. And then I would see what emerged in the lines and then begin to react and build the images from there. So it's always been amazing to me to watch as things that are important to me or precious in my life emerge out of these seemingly random lines. So the painting Autumn, that was one of the very early one I did, emerged in that way, and it was all about the Bradford pears that I had been looking at around me for a month before, with just a few brilliant red autumn leaves in them and crows flying around through them. Often I find that I'm actually connected in some way myself to the work that I didn't imagine, so that it was after I painted Autumn that I realized that I was actually, in a way, both of the crows, the one chasing, the one being chased. When I painted the painting Glee, I was wondering, you know, what if people's minds were like houses? What would they be like? What would be on top of each person's head if that's the way that worked? And could I, you know, laugh right out loud if that was me, if that was my mind? It wasn't until after I'd finished the painting, the placement of the figures and so forth being, again, largely because of where random lines ended up, that I realized that one of the other figures had a white house with green shutters on its head. And it's the house I grew up in New York, or a representation of it. And I realized that actually I was in the painting twice. Sometimes what emerges is really hard, like the grief over the loss of my father. Other times I'm just channeling what I'm hearing, which could be, you know, the loud cicadas of summertime and the memories I have of early summers in my own life, in my childhood. When we were doing the Rockabye Baby project and beginning the paintings, I used the same process. And including on top of that, then looking at hundreds and hundreds of pictures of babies and young mothers in order to come up with composites of the figures I needed. I did not have any model to work with from this to get the figures to come out the way I wanted to. So I ended up using and looking at hundreds and hundreds of photos on the internet. For instance, when the line about the baby falling, it was really impossible to either model a baby falling or find photographs of babies falling on the internet. However, what I could find, it occurred to me, is I could find people tossing their babies in the air or babies in swings. And from hundreds of photos like that, I was able to piece together what I thought it might look like if a baby was falling with their toes extended and their hands and arms out. And so that's what led to the image in that painting. I hope you'll consider supporting our project or finding at least one other person who will, because either one will bring this to life for children. Thank you.